the risk of transcatheter aortic valve replacement are pretty limited at this point. We've come a long way in the 15 years that the procedure has been utilized. We've done a lot of the research here in the United States as well as abroad and have learned to make it less and less traumatic and less risky. We did start, in fact, with the riskiest of patients, those who are really inoperable and the most frail. And now we've been able to apply it to lower and lower risk patients. The risk, obviously, that everybody worries about most is whether they're going to survive the procedure. The risk for this procedure is down around 2%, which is quite low, and in fact lower than most surgical risks for patients who have surgical aortic valve replacement. The second most scary thing is stroke. And at the beginning, we were having stroke rates that were in the 5 to 10% range, and now it's under 1%. So not zero. However, we do know if we don't treat these patients, they have 100% chance of getting worse. We take a limited and hopefully controlled risk of death and stroke of under 2% or even under 1%, knowing that you've reversed the ratio completely from 100% chance of getting worse and not doing well long-term. Aortic stenosis, which is the reason we utilize transcatheter aortic valve replacement, is as lethal as many cancers. In fact, if you have symptoms from it, about 50% of the patients are not alive at 2 years if they go untreated. So we take it very seriously when somebody comes in with aortic stenosis and has symptoms, which can be chest pain, it can be shortness of breath, it can be dizziness, and even fainting. That we try to promptly treat these patients if we can, whatever is the best technology available, whether it's surgery or whether it's transcatheter aortic valve replacement, try to move very quickly towards therapy.